flap folds, flap decentrations, epithelial defects, epithelial ingrowth, inconsistent flap, and flap wrinkles. Let's look at case number one. The flap infold noticed a few hours after surgery. The flap is everted. Two dry sponges should be used to iron out the folds on the back surface of the flap. Repeated use of hypotonic saline is used to hydrate the flap and hence assist to iron out the folds. The direction of the movement of the sponge to iron out the striae should be perpendicular to the direction of the striae. The flap is placed back. Notice the vertical fold. But this will not be seen on the next day. On examination on the next day, the vertical fold disappears. Another case of a nasal hinge and a decentered inferior flap notice after the first 24 hours, in which the epithelium has already healed. All the epithelium from the stromal surface is removed and the flap is gently irrigated and repositioned into position. The back surface of the flap is then ironed with the use of hypotonic saline and two dry sponges. The hypotonic saline is used to hydrate the flap and iron out the folds with the same action of the two dry sponges. The flap is repositioned and these folds disappear the next day. Another case of an epithelial defect after the flap creation. To prevent the same in the other eye, as a precaution, one has to put a drop of methyl cellulose after the suction ring is applied and then proceed to make the flap. This prevents the friction of the microperitoneum head and hence the absence of the epithelial defect in the other eye. Managing another flap complication of an epithelial ingrowth. The white plaque that is seen is in the interface. This has to be tackled if it is found to be progressive or if it encroaches the central pupillary area. The flap is lifted and the stromal bed is scraped off of all the epithelial cells possible. The back surface of the flap is then tackled off the ingrowth. The flap is gently held with the help of the sponge and then the ingrowth is slowly, gently being peeled off. It is quite easy to peel this ingrowth off the back surface of the flap. This has to be gently done by a bimanual technique, with the sponge in one hand and the forceps in the other. Once this is completed, the flap is repositioned into position. Another case of an inconsistent flap thickness. One can see a partial buttonhole, but in such a case, one can proceed to complete the ablation without any effect on the visual outcome for the patient. The last case of managing a flap complication of wrinkles notice after day 7. For a good iron out of the wrinkles, the epithelial debridement is a must. This epithelial debridement is essential on the central optical zone. Post epithelial debridement, the flap is thinner. From a 110 flap thickness, if 60 microns remains, the flap becomes much thinner. So additional care has to be taken when this flap has to be lifted. This additional care is to prevent a buttonhole or a flap tear. The direction of the movement of the two dry sponges to iron out the strie should be perpendicular to the direction of the strie. Once this is done on the back surface of the entire flap, the flap is gently irrigated back into position and a bandage contact lens is placed for the first 24 hours. This gives excellent post-op results. Thank you.
Thank you.